Hello guys, welcome to this Java tutorial for beginners. In our today's video, we will talk about the uses of funnel keyword in Java. So without wasting time, let's get started. Now let us understand the use of keyword funnel. So the keyword funnel can be used with the declaration of class variable or a method, right? And it cannot be used with an interface. So now first we will understand how it can be used in conjunction with a variable. So here we have this variable i1, which is of the integer type, and I have assigned the value of 2. And later on in our next line, what I do is I try to reassign the value, and now I set it to the 3, right? And on my next line, I just print the value. Similarly, on my line 11, I have this final variable. So this final variable i2 is assigned with the value of 5, and on my line 12 I reassign with the value of 4, and similarly on my next line I just print the value i2, right? So first let me run this program and see what happens. Now let me compile the program, and here you can see we have the compilation error on line 12, which states that cannot assign a value to the final variable i2. Let me comment this statement on line 12 and run the program once again. So let me comment this and run the program once again. Now let me compile the program. So our compilation error is gone. So let me run it. And here we have the output as 3 and 5. So whenever you declare a variable as funnel, and if you try to reassign the value to that variable, then you will get the compilation error. This is because, whenever you declare the funnel keyword with your variable, then it simply means that a variable is a constant. That is, you cannot reassign any other value. All right. Now let us see what happens if I mark a class as funnel. So here on line 3, we have a funnel class A, right? So let me try to compile and run the program. Now let us compile and execute the program. So let us run it. And as you can see, the program ran successfully. Now I have modified the program. So here on line 5, I have the statement class B extends A, right? So let me try to compile this program now. Now let us compile the program. So here you get the compilation error. Cannot inherit from final A, right? So whenever you mark your class funnel, then it cannot be extended by another class. And if you try to do so, then you'll get the compilation error. Now, there is one more thing that you need to know about the funnel keyword. That is, your abstract class cannot be marked as final, because if you try to do so, then you'll get the compilation error, as our abstract class needs to be extended. All right. So we use funnel keyword in a class to prevent inheritance. All right. Now let us see what happens if I declare a method as final. So here in this program, we have this two methods A and B, and in our class A, the method B is declared to be final. And on line 8, we have our class B, which extends the class A, right? And we are overriding the methods A and B respectively. So now let me try to compile the program. Now let us try to compile the program. So here we get the compilation error on line 10. B method in class B cannot override B method in class A, and it states that the overridden method is final. So in Java, the purpose of your funnel method is to prevent it from being overridden. And if you try to do so, then you will get the compilation error, which we got in our program. So if I remove the statement, public void B from line 10, and now if I run this program, the program should run successfully. Now let me compile the program, and you can see the compilation error is gone. So let me run it. And now the program ran successfully. So that is it for today's video. And don't forget to subscribe for more Java programming videos like this. And I will see you until next time.